لكل شيء إذا ما تم نقصان، فلا يغرى بطيب العيش إنسان. هي الأمور كما شهدتها دول، من سره زمن سأته أزمان. وهذه الدار لا تبقي على أحد، ولا يدوم على حل لها شان.
بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه، أما بعد. One of the beautiful incidents of the seerah which occurred after our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam went public with his da'wah, and it is a well-known incident reported in all of the books of seerah, was when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's preaching became known to the Quraysh, and it started causing tensions within families. Brother was pitted against brother, uncle against a cousin, so it became an issue of the entire city getting involved. And one of the senior members of the Quraysh by the name of Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, he was in the delegation of the Nadwa, that was their parliament, if you like. He was one of the senior MPs. The Quraysh did not have one chieftain. After Ibn Abdul Muttalib, they didn't have one king. They had all of the chieftains basically in a parliament. And one of the members was Utbah ibn Rabi'ah. And he asked the delegation, he asked the Congress, the Nadwa, he asked them, "Do you authorize me to negotiate on your behalf and to make some conditions so that we can end all of this tension?" They said, "Anything, as long as he stops preaching this message." So Utbah ibn Rabi'ah went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, found a time and place that there was nobody there in front of the Kaaba. By the way, who is Utbah? Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, he is the father-in-law of Abu Sufyan. His daughter is Hind, and the one that, you know, the Hamza incident, Hind. This is the father of Hind. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah is the one that when the incident of Ta'if happened, Utbah was the one that said to the Christian slave, "Go and give the grapes." That was the garden that belonged to Utbah outside of Ta'if. When he saw the Prophet ﷺ, he saw what happened, he had a merciful moment that this is my nephew. He was from the Quraysh. He is the second cousin of the father of the Prophet ﷺ. So he's from the Quraysh, but he is not from the exact lineage. And by the way, Utbah also is the one in the Battle of Badr. In the Battle of Badr, when the Prophet ﷺ was lined and he saw the Quraysh on the other side, and they saw a man with a turban around his face, and he was on a red camel, meaning a very expensive, very beautiful camel, rushing in the front of the ranks. And they couldn't hear what he was saying. But the Prophet ﷺ knew, because Allah told him, Jibreel told him what the man is saying. The Prophet ﷺ said, "If there is any good in the people, they will listen to the man on the red camel." This is Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, okay? "If there is any good, they'll listen to the sensible advice of the man on the red camel." Later on, they found out the man on the red camel was Utbah ibn Rabi'ah. And what was he telling his people? He was telling his people, "Oh my people, why are you killing your own blood? These are your own cousins. Who's gonna benefit? Let them believe in another religion. Who cares? You're killing them." So he was advising them to not go to war because he felt it to be petty. Utbah was, we would call him a very, you know, right-wing nationalist. He was proud of his tribe. And yes, he didn't like the religion of Islam, but he wasn't wanting to kill the Muslims because they're of a different faith. He wanted to be a Qurashi, pure Qurashi. And he wanted stability over theology, right? He cared about the prestige of the Quraysh over the religion of the Prophet ﷺ. So anyway, back to the story. So he goes to the Prophet ﷺ and he says, and by the way, Utbah is maybe two decades older. The Prophet ﷺ is now 41, 42 years old, 43. Utbah is in his late 50s, early 60s. Utbah is this one of the senior members. He's seen the Prophet ﷺ as a child. He's an elder of the Quraysh. Another point of Utbah, he brought the wars of Fijar to an end. If you remember the days of Jahiliyyah, that civil war that took place, Utbah was the one who brought it to an end. He's a very respected member. So he goes to the Prophet ﷺ, he says, "Ya bin akhi, my nephew, isn't this enough? Haven't you caused enough problems? You have divided our qawm." Look, his paradigm is very different. What is he worried about? He's not worried. He wants to have unity.
He wants to have what we call the national sentiment. He wants to have the pride of the Quraysh. That's who he is. You have divided our people. You have caused families to be broken up. You have made one Qurayshi against another Qurayshi. You have considered our icons to be ridiculous, meaning the gods, right? These are our icons. Imagine if, you know, an American disrespect the flag, right? That's like, this is our icon. You know how they react. Similarly, he's saying, you have considered our icons to be ridiculous. And then he asked him, who is more knowledgeable, you or Abdul Muttalib? Meaning, Abdul Muttalib, he is your grandfather. How could you be correct and he be wrong? Who is more knowledgeable? أَنْتَ أَعْلَمُ Are you more knowledgeable than your own grandfather? And the Prophet was silent. Then he said, I am coming here to negotiate. And then the famous thing, if you want wealth, we will give you all the wealth in the world. If you want power, we will make you a member of the Shura, of the Nadwa, and no decision will take place except with your veto. We'll give you veto power. You will have the power of veto. And if you want, you know, if you have a disease, we will get you the best doctor. And if you want marriage, name any woman, we will make sure she marries you. Whatever bribe we're willing to give you, right? The Prophet ﷺ remained quiet. Then he said, أَفَرَغْتَ يَا أَبَا الْوَلِيدِ Are you now done, O Abu al-Walid? Because his son is Walid ibn Utbah. Are you done, O Abu al-Walid? He said, yes. So then the Prophet ﷺ said, listen to what I have to say. Then he began reciting Surah Fussilat. حَامِيم تَنْزِيلُ مِنَ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ كِتَابٌ فُصِّلَتْ آيَاتُ And he recited until he came to the verse. And Abu al-Walid Utbah, he had put his hands back. And he's now sitting, listening, as an elder man. He's sitting with the breast on his back, with his hands like this. And he's listening, and his face is changing. By the way, I always mention this, subhanAllah, when we listen to Manshawi Abdul Basit Husari, the mashallah, the king of Qurra, how we are affected, right? Can you imagine if we heard the tilawa of the Prophet ﷺ, what would have happened? Can you imagine hearing his recitation? May Allah grant us that in Jannat al-Firdaus, inshaAllah ta'ala. So Utbah is listening to the Prophet ﷺ's tilawa. His whole face is changing until finally the Prophet ﷺ comes to the verse. فَإِنْ أَعْرَضُوا If they reject this message, فَقُلْ أَنْذَرْتُكُمْ صَاعِقَةً مِثْرَ صَاعِقَةَ عَدٍ وَثَمُودَ I'm warning you of a lightning bolt that will destroy them like Ad and Thamud were destroyed. And it's a crescendo, it's building up. If you read the verses, they're powerful. By this time, Utbah jumps up and he puts his hand on the mouth of the Prophet and he says, I beg you by Allah, stop. This is a threat and I'm worried. I beg you by Allah, stop. Don't go further. I just stop here. So the Prophet ﷺ said, okay, you have heard what I have to say. فَأَنْتَ وَشَأْنُكَ It's up to you what you want to do. Then the story goes on. So many benefits, but the point I wanted to just bring here, small benefit, subhanAllah, look at the infinite adab and wisdom of dialogue of our Prophet ﷺ. Wallahi, it is mind-boggling. You know, when two of us Muslims get involved in a debate or a dispute, we don't even show a fraction of wisdom, of rahmah, of common sense. Our Prophet ﷺ is having a dialogue with a pagan, an idol worshipper, a Qurayshi. And in the course of this dialogue, he is being insulted to the highest degree of insults. You want money? We'll give you money. What an insult to the honor and dignity of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do you think he wants money? You want power? You want women? A'udhu billah. This is an insult of the highest magnitude. And what is he doing? Quiet. Go ahead. More. Ask me more. No problem. Right? And the question as well, are you more knowledgeable or Abdul Muttalib? Now we are insulted, but from his paradigm, it's a common sense question. Who are you, O grandson of Abdul Muttalib? You're a nobody compared to him. From his paradigm is different. And notice the wisdom. Not a single one of these insults the Prophet ﷺ responded to. Why? Because it's hopeless. Do you expect the Prophet ﷺ to say, I am more better than my grandfather? And Abu al-Walid or Utbah is going to understand? His paradigm is so different that to merely say the Prophet ﷺ is better is going to be falling on deaf ears. This is what you call wisdom. You choose your battles and you choose when to speak and when to be quiet and you choose what to say. And he didn't even respond to all of those bribes out of dignity. Not even responding, just complete ignoring. And this is the sign of a dignified critic, subhanAllah. And then what did he do? He presented to him, go read Surah Fussilat, we don't have time to go into that, go read it. He presented to him the message of Islam. And the first page and a half of Surah Fussilat talks about Tawheed, it talks about Risala, it talks about Akhirah. And then it ends with a threat that if you turn away, Allah Azza wa Jal is there. And that's when Abu al-Walid jumped and said, enough is enough. From this we learn, and inshallah with this we conclude. Dear brothers in Islam, subhanAllah, what a beautiful manner here. That when you are engaging in dialogue, understand the goal is not that you show that you are better than the other person. The goal is to genuinely convince the person. And how you convince the person, generally speaking, is by respecting the dignity and the time. In fact, he even asked Abu al-Walid, are you done now? He let him go on and on and on. Next time you see a debate between two Muslims, you will see they will not even let the first person finish the sentence before the other one interjects and thinks he's refuting. They won't even let you finish the sentence. And here, the Prophet ﷺ is sitting, go ahead, quiet, go ahead, more, more, more. When he's done, he even asks him, anything else, anything left? This shows you simple common sense adab. And then also the wisdom in how you respond, right? The paradigms are so different that the Prophet ﷺ would not even have been, you know, successful if he tried to negotiate with Abu al-Walid. I don't want money. That would be insulting to even say that. Oh, I am better than Abdul Muttalib. That would not fly on his ears. So you just ignore that and you move to your solid points. And the solid points are what? The Quran, Tawheed, Risalah. In any case, this beautiful anecdote is full of wisdom, and it shows us the dignity of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and it shows us some etiquettes of how we debate and dialogue. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cause us to benefit from the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Inshallah, we'll continue later on. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Ya man ajabta du'a Nuhin fantasar wa hamaltahu fi fulkika al-mashhun ya man أحال النار حول خليله روحا وريحانا بقولك كون